What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're getting back to our roots a little bit. We have all the ingredients here to make a pizza. I know what you're thinking, Rem, you're on keto. How are you gonna eat pizza? It's actually a good question. I was curious myself. I see all these people making keto recipes. I've had lots of comments. You guys want to see a keto pizza. So if you're, hey, why not? This is my first time ever making one. We'll make it live here on the channel. I'll give you guys the step-by-step breakdown. We'll give it a taste and see, you know, if this compares to a regular pizza that you could have on a regular diet. It's actually not right. Probably aren't eating pizza on a regular diet, but you guys get the point. So if you guys are ready, get this started, man. Let's do it! The best part about this recipe is it is only 6 ingredients. Really easy. I find the simplest path to success is keeping things as simple as possible. So moving in, ingredient number 1, you're gonna need some mozzarella cheese. I go with finely shredded. It's gonna be way easier to mix up and get in the consistency we need for this recipe. You're gonna need about 2 bags since we're gonna use one layer to actually make the crust and the other layer as cheese for the, I know what you're thinking, cheese crust, but pay attention, I'm telling you. It's supposed to be really good. We also have some coconut flour, help us reach that consistency that we need. We'll have to use traditional flour with all the carbs knocking us out of ketosis. So coconut flour is ideal for that, high in fiber, really good for keto, really good for these recipes. And then it wouldn't be a pizza without some pizza sauce. Now this is where it gets a little tricky. A lot of this sauce is gonna have added sugars and added carbs you do not want. So we looked for a while to find one that didn't have any added sugar. So we're only gonna get about 2 grams of sugar from this in the overall recipe, which is ideal. You have too much sugar, you're gonna throw the recipe off somewhere and knock you out of ketosis, not good for any party involved. And then pepperoni, baby. Wouldn't be a pizza without pepperoni. Once again, we're not doing like turkey pepperoni or anything like that. We're keeping the full fat in here to make sure this is optimal for keto. So no need to look at anything like that. Now, if you want a healthier option, maybe you need more protein, or maybe you want, I don't know, less fat, or you don't like pepperoni, chicken, anything like that, ground beef, whatever your pizza preference is. You're also gonna need some cream cheese. We went ahead and decided to use organic here. And once again, this is a little outside of my element because I'm not used to buying the full fat versions. Normally if I'm buying cream cheese, I'm buying reduced sugar or low fat, whatever. But like this, you just want the regular good old fashioned cream cheese because all that fat we need for this diet. And then the final ingredient, I think I covered everything else. We got 2 large eggs here, brown style, since we were over at Grant's using his oven because mine is broke. But for the most part, that is all we're gonna really need. And then on top of that, I would recommend some parchment paper. That way when we bake this, it's gonna stay non-stick to the pan, give us a real nice crust we can take on and off. And then you'll need some measuring cups, and then we have, is this a pizza circle?
It is. It's pizza stove? Yep, it's for making pizzas in the oven.
Well, I got one of those, so I'm already glad we came here, man. All right, so this is super easy. Let's get started on this. I'm telling you guys, it'll be game changer. Let's go. First thing we have to do is take our mixing bowl here and put 28 grams of our cream cheese in there. So we already weighed that out. Boom, we got 28 grams. We are good to go. And then now we need 168 grams of our cheese here, which ironically enough, these bags are weighed out to about that by default. So not too bad. Dump that right in there. Okay, so we got the 168 plus 28, 190. Yep, math works out good. So now we have this. We got to throw it in the microwave. Let's go. So we need this in the microwave for a grand total of about 90 seconds. What you want to do is split that into 2 different sessions. So we're going to do 45 seconds at first, then we're gonna pull it out and we're gonna stir it all up and then give it another 45 seconds. Pretty simple here. This is getting it melted down, so it's our consistency we need for the crust. Okay, 45 seconds. So look down in here, see how this is basically about halfway melted. You wanna go in, kind of stir it all up a little bit, help that consistency out, get some of these sticking edges off. Boom, and then we'll wanna make sure we're not leaving anything on our fork here. So boom, bingo, so that's good. Now we're gonna throw it back in for another 45, and then that will be ready to go. So this is what it's gonna look like after that time in the microwave. Look at that consistency right there, but we are not done yet. So what we need is a 1/3 cup of our coconut flour right here. So I got a 1/3 cup, I'll get down in here, get a little, looks good to me. Add that in, help us get that dough consistency. And then the next ingredient we're gonna add is 2 large eggs. So I'm just gonna take it, I'm gonna do yolk and all because we want that fat in there, that protein. Boom, 2, boom, perfect. And then once you get everything in there, what you're gonna wanna do is go in here and stir it all up. And you really wanna spend some time with this. You wanna get all the ingredients really bonded together. That way we can get that crust consistency that we need. And then once it's all mixed up, it should look something like this. That looks like traditional pizza dough. So you're gonna go in with your hands and kind of further along the process, make sure everything's mixed up. After this, what we're gonna do is once this is in a good enough spot, I'll probably take some of this down here, kind of add it back in so we're not leaving any macros on the table. I got our little pizza circle right here. Is that the right word, a pizza circle?
I don't know.
Well, we got parchment paper on it so it doesn't stick. So we're gonna take this and we're gonna shape our pizza dough once this is good. And that looks good to me. So now we're gonna go in here and shape our dough out. We're gonna flatten it because it's gonna cook better if it's thinner. Kind of press it in and shape it into whatever you want. I mean, it doesn't gotta be a circle. You can make a starfish if you wanted to. I guess it depends what kind of pizza you like, but kind of how I choose to do it. And all right, I think we're ready for the oven. Now what we gotta do is put this in the oven for 10 minutes at 425 degrees. So we've already had our oven preheating. I'm gonna put it right in there. Let that harden a little bit for the crust. Close it up. Set ourselves a timer here. 10 minutes, boom. 10 minute timer good. Once it's done, we'll be right back. So this is what the crust is gonna look like after 10 minutes in the oven. So as you can see, it's already kind of getting our consistency. It's not fully done yet though, because you're gonna see what the next steps are. But at this point, go through and just poke some holes in it with a fork. That way our second round in the oven, it doesn't like bubble up. Perfect. Now, at this point, we are gonna add our sauce to it, which we're only gonna do a quarter cup of sauce, which should be more than enough. So I've already measured it out. We'll get down here, add it right there in the middle, then grab a spoon and kind of get it all, you know, pizza sauce spread out. I don't think anybody wants your pizza sauce all in the middle. That's gonna be good. And then now we're gonna do half a cup of that same mozzarella cheese back on top here. This time I'm gonna kind of spread it around. There we go. And then I'll use my hands to kind of get it mixed up in here. All right, that looks good. And then the final ingredient, the one thing I'm probably looking the most forward to, is our pepperonis. We are only using 8 though. We're not gonna go too crazy. I guess if you could factor into your macros, you could do more than that, but keeping this macro friendly for y'all. Like I said, you can tweak this really any way you want. It's a pretty simple formula. 7 and 8, boom. How's that look? Does it look good?
Beautiful.
Looks like a Lunchables pizza.
It does.
You know what I mean? But after we bake it, I think we'll be in for a surprise. Back in the oven. And at this point, it just needs 10 more minutes in the oven. Same temperature, same everything. So, woo, slide her in, boom. Close it up once again. 10 minutes, start, and we're good. At the next clip, this pizza will be done. We'll give it a test and see if it lives up to the hype. So after that 10 minutes in the microwave, this is what we are working with here. Now, I will say, being here in person, being able to like actually see it, I mean, you guys can see it too, but like just like looking at it, if someone delivered that to me at a restaurant, I wouldn't really think that it wasn't regular pizza, right? Just by looking at it, let's do cut test. Boom. Seems to be cutting just right. All right, 4 slices. Let's go ahead and give this a try here. Get a piece. All right, what are you thinking, Grant? Is it gonna be good?
It looks good. It smells good.
Right?
Let's see.
All right, guys. Oh, we're gonna bring it back. 3, 2, 1, let's go. All right, that is actually really good. I'm gonna take this way back. Do you guys remember back when you were kids, it was like Chef Boyardee boxed pizzas? Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, and like how that crust was like always kind of like a little thicker and a little more.
Yeah.
That's what this crust tastes like.
Oh.
Yeah, and it's actually.
Looks good.
How are there no carbs in this?
I don't know.
Big Fern in the house.
What's up, guys?
All right, we need a second opinion on this pizza. You've been here for the whole making process.
I have.
I want you, I'll be want honest opinions. Ooh, right here.
Good cheese pull.
Nice right little there. Cheese pull.
All right, here we go. Ready?
Yep. Well, honest opinion.
Mmm.
Right.
It does remind me of that pizza you're talking about.
Yeah.
That tastes like actual crust though.
It doesn't it though?
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I want to know that's like cheese. And
exactly.
Yeah.
Those are the best recipes, man. The ones where you're not like, eh.
Mm.
Like if someone pulled this out at a party or something, man, I'm all over that.
Wait, where's this from?
Exactly.
I'm gonna order it. Yeah. That's good.
Do you have any BOGO offers?
No.
Awesome. So does it get the double seal of approval?
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Double seal.
That's what we're all about here on the channel, baby.
We are.
Best part about this pizza too is the macros in this entire thing. There's 19.5 grams of fat, 3.6 grams of carbs, and 16 grams of protein, whopping 250 calories. I mean, that's like one slice of pizza anywhere else. So, I mean, for me, this is a win, man. This might be one of the best recipes I've ever done.
Agreed.
Real talk, as far as just like emulation, because I've done some other pizzas in the past that were a little iffy, man. The cauliflower one, don't do it yourself. Mmm, this is great, man. Dope. Ah, another successful recipe. Got a busy next few days. I will be leaving again for LA. We're gonna be vlogging and all that stuff, you know, figuring out this move and everything. Been super busy lately, guys, but the videos are still coming out. So if you enjoy this, make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Like I said, full ingredients, instructions, everything will be in the description box below. So check it out, make it yourself, man. This is easy, and it was Grant approved, double seal approved.
Yep, what else can you guys ask for?
Yeah, come I know, on. What else can I ask? I can't even talk about that. All right, we're out of here. Thank you guys so very much for watching. And as always, don't forget to smile, remain positive, and pay someone a compliment, because you never know whose day you can make them better. With that, we are out of here. This has been Remington James Production. I will see you fine, ladies and gentlemen, at the next video. See you guys. I mean, for real, man.
Yeah.
This is.
I want another piece.